Well, Stephanie, this story was much like the one we heard before New England regulators in New Hampshire 2 weeks ago. This time, state politicians were asking the questions.
The president of Fairpoint Communications tried to put his best face on the company's progress since a rocky takeover of Verizon last year.
Let me acknowledge the transition has inconvenienced many of our customers in Vermont and the other two states.
In a hearing before Vermont lawmakers, Fairpoint said it has lost 9% of its residential phone customers in the last year to competition. And for the first time, Vermont now has more cell phones than landlines. Still, most new orders for service are hooked up in 4 days, and that's a big improvement. DSL expansion into rural areas is running ahead of schedule. And Fairpoint is also bullish about a next-generation broadband technology they are now testing in Milton.
So despite what you hear and read, there are a lot of customers eager to buy services from Fairpoint?
Still, Fairpoint is a major concern across northern New England, in large part because the company appears so close to bankruptcy, and state watchdogs are pushing hard.
We seek a fundamentally restructured Fairpoint from a financial and managerial standpoint, or alternatively, a sale to a viable new owner or operator.
The phone company countered that with more time, by the end of the year perhaps, it will show the region it can perform.
And we are absolutely committed to do whatever it takes.
Well, the markets sure see a company in trouble. Fairpoint stock has lost 95% of its value in recent months. The company is clearly trying to restructure its debt short of entering Chapter 11 bankruptcy protection. But even then, we heard again today, Fairpoint's president said that customers will see no interruption in service. Live in the Vermont newsroom, Stuart Ledbetter, News Channel 5.